Hello everyone. I wanna go ahead and discuss something that someone commented on my previous video. I wished like the video name and link will be below for you and you're interested to see what we discussed. This blog and in response to someone comment what they said. Spoken on Gallaudet University had a long history of enduring the problem. Their PR department had worked hard to connect with Deaf people over the years, and I applaud them. But that doesn't make up for all the damage that has been happening. One of the bigger areas of concern is the safety of students. They responded pretty well to COVID and how they handle masks, vaccine, the police danger in that. But the safety of BIPOC students has been a huge problem. And as many of you know, there was Gallaudet Cheerleader that was talking to for being trained. Then it's very concerning because Gallaudet seemed to respond in a way that a lot of the world really broken up restorative justice. I want to stop there. It is important to look at restorative justice and transformative justice. How that works needs to happen in a way that's the least amount of harm to the survivor. To have four football players taught, bullying, and training cheerleader is unacceptable. Now I want to back and ask you how we have responded if they was general student, not student that will put on the football team. I think also important to point out what the coach said. In that comment they point out to, I want to thank you for making that comment because back to the whole classroom information balance within the deaf community, violence and de-violence. We want us to look deeper and look at how we allow people to behave. Restorative justice doesn't mean to ignore consequences. There needs to be consequences in action, but what the consequences look like depends on how they want to restore. So, are they going to really think about what's best for the student? Or is this about making excuses for how to respond to this situation? This scenario is very scary because now Gallaudet has to look at how they've been treating people. Bobby Cordon has the history of being someone that truly is not trans-friendly. She may be lesbian, but as many of you LGBTQ community members know, just because you're a brother LGBTQ doesn't mean that everyone that identifies as queer will be trans-friendly. This is a lot of things that many people begin or don't have full access to that information. They don't understand. And this is where the harm is happening. How the school is responding? Are they suspending football player? Well, Gallaudet has a great record this year. Right now, the track record is pretty good. But how are they handling that with these specific football player? What are they doing to restore the harm? there's a real question here. What do you think? What have you seen Gallaudet truly do? If you're a student, please feel free to email me, because I would love to know more about what this means. What does restorative justice look like at Gallaudet?